Namaste. Today the paper that I am presenting is about Parakiya Nayikas. Nayikas are popularly divided into Sviya, Parakiya and Samanya Nayika. Parakiya Nayika is that Nayika who does not belong to the hero. She is either a married woman who loves another man or an unmarried girl who is under the dictatorship of her father and loves a man. Infidelity is supposed to be one of the Panchamahapapas according to ancient Indian texts. She was considered a Nicha character, a character who was not even supposed to be as a main character in the Natakas. But today, she is the highest form of bhakti or devotion. Let's see how this transition happened. The earliest reference of a Parakiya Nayika is found in Puranas like Bhagavata Purana, Brahmavaivarta Purana, Vishnu Purana and so on. Here Krishna is found in dalliance with gopis. Later we find songs of Arvars where the Arvar saints not only wrote about the dalliance of Krishna with the gopis but also imagined themselves to have sported Krishna. Ramanujacharya supports this literature with his Vishishta Advaita philosophy. Here, bhakti is considered a form of meditation. Later, Nimbarka, with his philosophy, brings bhakti as a form of love and devotion. And that forms the basis of today's Parakiya literature. Parakiya Nayika is popularly divided into a Kanya, and an Anud, Paroda. A Paroda is that Nayika who is married to another man but loves another man. Kanya is the Nayika who is unmarried under her father's directorship but in love with another man. Rasamanjari brings in the first kind of divisions to the Parakiya, followed by which Akbar Shah in Shringara Manjari improvises the divisions. The first kind of division, seen in Shringara Manjari, is where a Parakiya is divided into Udbuddha and an Udbhodita. An Udbuddha is that Nayika in whom love is infused by the hero. The hero lures the Nayika. She is further divided, like any other Proudha Nayika, into Dhira, Adhira and Dhira Dhira. The Udbodhita Nayika is the one in whom love sprouts by itself. She is divided into Gupta, Nipuna and Lakshita. Gupta is further divided into Vritta Surata Gopana, Vartishyamana Surata Gopana, Vritta Vartishyamana Surata Gopana. Nipuna is none other than Vidagda as mentioned in Rasamanjari. Bhanudatta mentions two kinds of Vidagdas, Karya Vidagda and Vak Vidagda, while Shringara Manjari talks about Karya Nipuna, Vang Nipuna and Pativanchana Nipuna. Lakshita is further divided into Prachana Lakshita and Prakasha Lakshita. Prachana Lakshita is where the friends figure out about the love affair through her activities, and Prakasha is when she's bold and it's found through her activities itself. Prakasha Lakshita is further divided into Kulata, Mudita, Sahasika and Anushayana. To find out how a Parakiya Nayika must be portrayed in dance, we have to understand the lyrics written by the saint poets and stalwarts who were there in the field. We find various situations of a Parakiya Nayika, where she invites the hero, she tells him that this is not the apt time for union and asks him to go away. Situations where she feels, she wonders how he must be feeling because she did not attend to him immediately. There are situations where she says, she requests him to keep it as a secret and not tell anyone about it. To mention a few, these are the situations. From all this, what can be understood is that a Parakiya Nayika is very secretive about her affair. She is guilty and is aware that it must be kept as a secret. So when performing such pieces, it must be kept in mind that there must be subtlety in handling this. She should not advance towards an uninterested man. Another kind of Parakiya Nayika is visible in the Madhura Bhakti or the Bhakti Shringara pieces. Swamiye Arithodiva, Sakhiye, Kumara Swamiye Arithodiva. Pieces like this, where the Nayika is in love with her god. Here, the Nayika is a Parakiya Nayika. In this particular piece, she is neither Valli nor Devyani. So she is not a Sviya. And she is definitely not a Samanya. There is no indications of that. So here, she is a Parakiya Nayika. She belongs to this Maya world. And she yearns to be with the hero. Allegorically, the husband is the Maya, the world, the society from which she yearns to be pulled away to be with the Paramatma. It's the eternal longing of every Jivatma to be united with the Paramatma. So when such pieces are performed, it must be remembered that a small tinge of devotion must be mixed. Bhakti and Shringara together. To have a better performance, every dancer must understand the depth of the character, the attributes of the character, the qualities of a character, and then perform the character. To have a better understanding of the characters, it is vital to read literatures that are already present about those characters. And then go on to present the character. Only then the rasa siddhi will happen. This paper on Parakiya Nayika will be presented in the dance symposium organized by Noopura Bhramari on August 12th at Kalagowri, Basavanagudi, Bangalore. Please come in large numbers and encourage the artists and the researchers. Namaste.